So I saw you through the TV as I was coming here because God has anointed you to save us. That's like this morning, early morning. I came here, I was sweeping the church. I said, I'm not going back. They said, where can you stay? Man of God, help me. I need your help.
You need direction.
Yes, man of God, help me.
You lay hands on people.
I pray for people, deliver people.
But they are blessed, you are not blessed.
They are not blessed, man of God. You were speaking to me this morning.
You are.
Lay hands on people, they deliver, they are saved, they are some of trouble.
Nothing. Because you are signing documents in someone's office. I will tell you where you need to sign your own documents. In the realm of the spirit, we are deeper. If you are in the deep, don't handle a problem in a deeper. Word of God does not work on assumption or test match. If you sign your own documents, when the people are blessed, you'll be blessed. Right now, your eyes are open. Come here. Open. God has friend with you.
I will not let him go.
Who are you?
I will not let him go. Why do you want to shut the door? The altar of his mother's side. The name after his name, you know, go. I've warned him, I've tied him. I've refused to serve me. You know, serve
altar. You are altar. You want him to serve you?
He will not go. He will not go. He will change life. I make it to suffer. I make it to struggle. I don't know what's in here. I don't know what's in here. Leave this boy, he's mine.
He's an altar. Why did I stop you from coming here?
Leave this boy, he's mine. He's an altar of his mother's height. He will not go. He will not go.
What is he doing for a living?
They dedicated it to me. He's troubling. He's what you saw that man up there. Nothing to show.
Which man?
That man up there.
That man up there.
That man up there. He loved that man up there.
You don't want him to serve the man up there?
He will not serve him. He will not serve him.
Who are you to say so?
He will not serve him.
Who are you?
I'm the altar of his mother house.
Did you know he was coming here?
They dedicated it to me. Leave this boy.
Do you see what's happening here now?
This nation. I
said, this man, he lay hands on people, but he doesn't know his calling. When God calls you, he will enable you. Before you can lay hands on somebody, you must know who you are laying hands on. That is, he will give you grace to know what to carry before you can know the opinion of God about other people.
This boy will not be set free.
He will not be set free.
Leave this boy.
You don't want him to be free.
I want all his blessing.
Uh-huh.
I want all his blessing. He cannot marry.
Listen.
He cannot succeed.
Why did you stop him from coming here?
I don't know who brings him here.
You don't know.
I don't know.
You are going.
I don't know.
You are going.
I will not go.
Hey,
I will not.
Leave him. I am sent to him. Today, his soul will encounter salvation.
Open your heart. Watch the power of God in action.
The battle between a general in the kingdom of light and a general in the kingdom of darkness. One must bow. Go!
Watch the temple of Satan.
You can clap up for unto Jesus Christ. Celebrate Master Jesus.
Open your heart to the Holy Spirit.
Pray for people. It is not just to stretch your hand and pray for people. You carry problems. You need a mentor. You need someone to help you to be able to know who you are praying for. If you don't know who you are praying for, you venture into that prayer, they will finish you. That's what happened to him. Come. Come.
It's just like I'm moving, calling people to go and pray for them. Open church this tomorrow, tomorrow day. He has nothing to eat, sir. He locked the door and being time that he's praying, praying.
What happened to you?
You come out, you see he has white.
Huh? Thank you. Thank you for serving.
Clap for Jesus.
Thank you, thank you.
He's crying. He has suffered. Satan has frustrated him. But today we give glory to God. It is honor. Rise up. It is okay. Stand up. He's from where?
From where? I stay with
him. Come. You stay with him.
Yes, Pastor. I don't do so.
So, I believe God, who has used me to set him free, will use me to point him to the future.
Amen.
Stand up.
Amen.
So, you pray for people.
Yes, man of God.
Lay hands on them.
Yes.
Yeah, they deliver, they send peace to my travel, but nothing to show. I cannot even eat, I cannot eat. This mama will help me to stay in this house. And nothing to show.
So don't worry. Where there is no vision, people perish.
Thank you, man.
So from today you will see vision.
Yes. Thank you, man of God. I am free. Thank you, man of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for setting me free. Thank you, Jesus. I am free forever. I am set free forever. Thank you, Jesus. My story has changed.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
My name is Apostle Roland Ebo. I'm coming from Bangem. I'm a Cameroon. I'm a Bakosian. So on the 14th of December, on the 26th of December 2014, God gave me a vision. I was going to break it down. And God gave me the backing of the ministry, the Vision of Fire Covenant Ministry, Life Com, which and God gave me Abraham to start the work. And on 2019, I started the work of God. And the ministry was moving. And I was praying for people. People were being delivered. People were being blessed. People were being given testimony. But my life was not changing. Things were so bad on my side.
Notre frère, il est aussi. Il est camerounais, il vient de Bangem. Le frère est bon. Il avait une vision que Dieu l'avait donnée en 2014, le 26 décembre, d'ouvrir un ministère qui s'appelait LifeCom. Et là, il devait prier pour des gens. Et il a ouvert ce ministère en 2019. Il a commencé à prier pour des gens.
So, as I was praying for people, people were being healed, people were being delivered. But my life was not changing. Things were so hard on me. I cannot even pay house rent. I cannot eat. Things were so difficult. Anywhere I go, things were hard. So there was an altar and my family brother was fighting me.
So this altar has
donc, il priait pour des gens, il délivrait les gens, mais sa vie n'allait pas bien. Il avait des difficultés, même ses propres besoins personnels n'arrivaient pas à y prendre soin. Donc, il a constaté qu'il y avait un hôtel familial dans la maison qui le bloquait.
So, there was power in my family, Bagala was fighting me. It was so severe that things were not going. So, I have to look for solution for people to pray for me. So I went to some churches to pray for me, but there was no way. The things were still the hard times and the things were still continuing. So because of these powers in the family, because of these powers, I was so frustrated, and I have to stop the ministry. Look for solution. And in the course of praying, we saw a vision where we saw the church was building, and in that mother's house we were worshiping each other, and the channel came in. We saw Apostle Marcel Chatty, and he was preaching, and the woman said that
that do I know this man? I say yes. And my spirit was telling me that this is a man that he will solve your problem.
Dans le cours de la vie, il a commencé à chercher des solutions. Au fur et à mesure, il a fermé son église, il a visité les différents pasteurs, les différentes églises pour chercher la délivrance à ses problèmes tels qu'il était rangé. Et un jour, pendant qu'il priait, il a eu une révélation. J'ai eu maman, ils ont mis la chaîne et la chaîne est apparue. Et l'apôtre Marcel Chatine prêchait. Et la maman lui a posé la question, est-ce que tu connais cet homme de Dieu? Et là, il a eu la révélation. Où il a reçu cette révélation que l'homme de Dieu s'il va lui délivrer.
So as an apostle of God, I never knew that I need direction for someone to direct me to or to go to deliverance.
Yes, because you're an apostle.
Huh? Yes, sir.
Because you're an apostle.
En tant qu'apôtre, tu n'as pas besoin de dirigeant ni penser.
How can an apostle look for another man of God to for direction for deliverance, whereas he is doing deliverance and giving prophecies?
Comment est-ce qu'un apôtre qui fait la délivrance cherche encore?
Is this not contradicting?
Ça contredit.
So after the call, I never knew that to go to deliverance because things were moving. So the powers of the family was still fighting me, and I went to many churches for prayers, but there was no solution. And there are many girls who come to my life to destroy my life, and things were not moving.
Il a rencontré plusieurs églises, ça n'a pas changé. Et il a vu qu'il y avait des filles qui venaient dans sa vie pour détruire sa vie. Et les choses n'allaient pas. Ça s'empirait de plus en plus. Il ne savait pas qu'il avait besoin d'une autorité plus haute et élevée pour qu'il ait une direction en tant qu'apôtre.
I know you are listening to it. You are asking such questions.
C'est quand vous posez les questions.
But you pray for people. Why this?
Tu pries pour les gens. Pourquoi ceci?
Because many of you believe that a man of God cannot receive attack. It's a lie.
Un homme de Dieu peut recevoir aussi des attaques.
Men of God receive the same attack you receive.
Les hommes de Dieu reçoivent des attaques comme vous.
Remember, no one is perfect.
Personne n'est parfait, rappelez-vous.
Amen.
Amen.
He is not a saint.
Il n'est pas un saint.
He is a human being.
C'est un être humain.
Attaque.
Attaqué.
Like any other person.
Comme n'importe qui ici.
But the mistake he is making.
Mais l'erreur qu'il commet.
Is in the area of his calling.
Dans le lieu de son appel.
That's where the mistake is coming from.
C'est là où l'erreur vient.
In the area of his calling.
Dans le lieu de son appel.
He has called.
Il a l'appel.
God said go into the assignment.
Dieu dit faire son devoir.
But he has not do away.
Mais il n'a pas rejeté.
With where he is coming from biologically.
De là où il sort.
So that he can connect where God wants to point him spiritually.
Il peut se connecter là où Dieu veut le diriger spirituellement.
That's where the attack is coming from.
C'est là où l'attaque vient.
One thing you must know is that.
Tu dois connaître que.
For you.
Pour toi.
To be linked to the blood of Jesus.
À être lié au sang de Jésus-Christ.
You must be cut off from your own biological bloodline.
Tu dois être délié de ton sang biologique.
Because your bloodline is corrupt with the blood of animals and goats that is sacrificed to mix up everything.
Ton lignée est corrompue avec le sang des choses, des animaux qu'on a fait pour faire.
Imagine a man like this.
Imagine un homme.
They
comme
give
ce...
birth to you.
On t'a accouché.
And they take you to an altar.
Et on t'amène sur un autel.
And dedicate you.
Et on te présente.
And along the way.
Et sur le chemin.
God called you.
Je t'ai appelé.
And point you to this altar of
et
God.
Et te dirige vers l'autel de Dieu maintenant.
If you don't cut yourself off from that altar.
Si tu ne te délies pas de l'autre autel.
You can never operate well in this altar.
Tu ne peux pas bien opérer sur cet nouvel autel.
It's like you are in between two altars.
Comme si tu es entre deux autels.
But the gift of discretion is to help you cut off from that one.
Mais le don de discrétion te délier de l'autre.
And the God that has called you will channel your way on this one.
Le Dieu qui t'a appelé va te lier à ce nouvel autel.
That is where the job needs to be done.
C'est là où on a travaillé.
So because of this problem I was having, even when I was still moving on the ministry, the man of God prophesied to me that there's a lady I have to marry, and I accepted a lady would be almost for 3 years, but the girl just want the sex, you know, and so I have to reject the marriage. And
wait, Pastor, Apostle, take your time and tell us this one now where we want to hear it. Apostle, it's a lesson for us. Tell us. He said they just prophesied. Just tell us, how did the whole thing happen?
Comment ça s'est passé?
So, there's a man of God in Moyoka which I went there, and I was worshiping in ministry. So
One pastor came there to preach. They were having a crusade in the ministry there. So I came there. That was my first day to come there for the crusade. And one of God who was preaching that day, I was sitting in front, and he said, "There's a pastor here. That your wife is here."
Okay, you did not come there with a girl.
No, I don't even know the girl. It's my first time to see the girl.
In fact, tell us more.
So when he said that, the man left the pulpit and come and hold my hand, and then go and hold the guest's hand, and we were dancing at the church, and he said, "This is my friend."
They join you together. Jump there and there, start dancing.
Yes, sir, start dancing. And we were dancing like that, the church closed, and then I went to see the mother. And the pastor went there, and the mother saw me, and he told the girl that you cannot marry this man. That when this man is going, you cannot marry this man. So I was teased with the girl bringing.
So just after church.
Just after church.
You went directly to the mother.
Went
to the mother. The dancing was hot. You two are posting. You don't know her, you are not studying her, you don't even know. Even you as an apostle, did you take your time to pray over it?
As you pray, she said that.
No, sir.
After that dancing, maybe the girl danced very well. One thing, it just go straight to the mother.
Yes, and through the prophecy, I went to the mother to know the family, mm-hmm. and to know their father and the mother, that they have said to the church that he is my wife, and I just came to know the family. But when the mother saw me, the mother said, "The daughter cannot marry this man."
Mm.
And I was surprised, and I asked the mother why. The mother cannot say anything.
Okay, you are already prepared for marriage too. Yeah, because if you ask the mother why, it means you need it now.
So, throughout the courtship, things were not just moving, and accusation all time. And in the ministry, it came to accusation that we are having an affair. The pastor said that we are having an affair with the lady, and that is how the team broke up, and the girls traveled to South Africa, and that's how everything ended. And
so now the prophecy got.
So after then, now God showed me a revelation. The pastor who prayed was begging me in the revelation that he prophesied wrongly, make a mistake, that he wanted me to marry the wrong wife. He prophesied wrongly, so I say I'm forgiving you.
You listen to this.
Vous entendez ceci.
You heard the message I'm preaching to you this morning.
Le message que j'ai prêché ce matin.
Don't look for the power.
Ne cherchez pas la puissance.
Look for the word.
Cherchez la parole.
The word will give you the power.
La parole te donnera la puissance.
God cannot say something.
Dieu ne peut pas dire quelque chose.
That he will not live to see it accomplished.
Que ça s'accomplira pas.
So the mistake is not only the man that told him.
L'erreur n'est pas juste l'homme qui l'a dit.
He too.
Lui-même.
In the midst of a lot of predicaments that were troubling him.
Parmi toutes ces tribulations qu'il avait,
he did fall for it. You play a role.
Il a joué un rôle également.
The man, after putting your hand, they did not force you to be dancing. You were lifting your legs by yourself to dance. So you play a role.
Tu as joué un rôle. On t'a lié, mais on t'a pas obligé de faire cela.
You play a role because you also fail to assess.
Tu as failli faire assess.
To take time.
D'observer.
To pray over it.
De prier sur cela.
I believe that.
Je crois que
the church will be asking questions now, such as,
l'église posera des questions comme,
did you know the girl before?
Est-ce que tu la connaissais auparavant?
Were you looking for a wife in that church?
Tu cherchais une femme dans cette église?
What took you there? Were you going for a wife?
Est-ce que tu partais pour une épouse?
When it came up, were you prepared for marriage at that time?
Étais-tu prête pour te marier à l'heure?
Such questions.
Ces genres de questions.
These are questions that you cannot answer here now.
Que because répondre,
you're supposed to have answers to this question before getting a wife.
Avoir des réponses.
Somebody cannot just get up and point a girl, say, "This is your wife." You just made it, just leave them, dance, and just went to see the parents.
On ne peut te montrer une femme, tu danses, tu ne pas voir les parents.
It's not a fowl that you want to buy in the market.
C'est pas un poule que tu payes au marché.
Hein? Uh-huh.
So, Since that time, as I started the ministry, I was praying for people. People were delivered, people were blessed, travel abroad, but my life was not changing. So I have to look for a solution. And when I came here in a new life ministry, everything become changed.
Dès qu'il cherchait la solution, dès qu'il est venu ici dans l'Alliance, dans le ministère de Nouvelle Alliance, dès qu'il a rencontré l'homme de Dieu, sa vie a changé.
So before I came here, I was so frustrated, I have nothing to eat, cannot pay house rent. Everything was upside down. So when I came here that fateful Sunday, and the revelation that we had, that I had, that is the place for my restoration. And when I came here on the prayer line, the man of God located me.
And I was shouting.
I said, man of God, help me. I've been praying for people and people have been healed, but my life is not changing. And the man of God have to pray for me. And when he prayed for me, he delivered me from the powers of my family that was fighting me. And from that day, I sleep like a baby. Everything become new. I can read the word of God, so excited me.
So I saw you through the TV. I saw most caviar because God has not sent you to save us. That's like this morning, early morning. I came here, I was sleeping in the church. I said, I'm not going back. They said, where can you stay? Man of God, help me. I need your help.
You need direction.
Yes, man of God, help me.
You lay hands on people.
I pray for people, deliver people.
But they are blessed, you are not blessed.
They are not blessed, man of God. You were speaking to me this morning.
You are.
Lay hands on people, they deliver, they are saved, they are some of taboo.
Nothing. Because you are signing documents in someone's office. Right now, your eyes are open. Come here. Open. God has friend with you.
Why do you want to shut the bomb? The altar of his mother's side. The name after his name, you know, go. I've warned him, I've tied him. I've refused to serve me. You know, serve
altar. You are altar. You want him to serve you?
You know, go. You know, go. He will change life. I make it to suffer. I make it to struggle. I don't know what's in here. I don't know what's in here. Leave this boy, he's mine.
He's an altar. Why did I stop you from coming here?
Leave this boy, he's mine. He's an altar of his mother's height. He will not go. He will not go.
What is he doing for a living?
They dedicated it to me. He's troubling. He's what you saw that man up there. Nothing to show.
Which man?
That man up there.
That man up there.
That man up there. He loved that man up there.
You don't want him to serve the man up there?
He will not serve him. He will not serve him.
Who are you to say so?
He will not serve him.
Who are you?
I'm the altar of his mother house.
Did you know he was coming here?
They dedicated it to me. Leave this boy.
Do you see what's happening here now?
This nation.
I said, this man, he lay hands on people, but he doesn't know his calling. When God calls you, he will enable you. Before you can lay hands on somebody, you must know who you are laying hands on. That is, he will give you grace to know what to carry.
Leave this boy.
Before you can know the opinion of God about
this
other people.
This boy will not be set free.
He will not be set free.
Leave this boy.
You don't want him to be free.
I want all his blessing.
Uh-huh.
I want all his blessing. He cannot marry.
Listen.
He cannot succeed.
Why did you stop him from coming here?
I don't know who brings him here.
You don't know?
I don't know.
You are going.
I don't know.
You are going.
I will not go.
Hey,
I will not.
Leave him! I am sent to him. Today, his soul will encounter salvation.
open your heart. Watch the power of God in action.
The battle between a general in the kingdom of light and a general in the kingdom of darkness. One must bow. Go!
Watch the temple of Satan. You can clap up for unto Jesus Christ. Celebrate Master Jesus.
Set free forever. Thank you, Jesus, my story.
Depuis ce jour-là, il est venu, il a passé par la ligne de prière. Donc, Dieu a prié pour l'en localiser. On l'a délié de toutes ces choses. Et dès qu'il est rentré à la maison, toutes ces choses, il dormait comme un bébé, il n'avait plus de difficultés et il se sentait être devenu un nouveau être humain.
As a Christian,
en tant que chrétien,
if you are a billionaire,
si tu es milliardaire
and you are still living in sin,
et tu demeures toujours dans le péché,
you end up as a debtor.
Tu vas rester comme quelqu'un qui a beaucoup de dettes.
That is the principle of life.
Voilà le principe de la vie.
Whatever you achieve,
tout ce que tu as acquis,
still in sin,
toujours dans le péché,
you will pay, sell it all, and you pay debts.
Tu vas tout vendre, tu vas payer les dettes.
That call upon your life cannot excel.
Ça ne peut pas exceller cet appel sur ta vie.
Because you need to do away.
Tu dois rejeter.
With the sinful nature.
La nature du péché.
As an apostle of God.
En tant qu'apôtre de Dieu.
A lot of mistakes.
Beaucoup des erreurs.
You have heard me here.
On a entendu parler.
The fact that you stretch your hand.
Le fait que tu tends tes mains.
And somebody fall down.
Quelqu'un tombe.
Does not mean that you are suitable.
Ne veut pas dire que tu es acceptable.
The fact that you speak in tongues.
Le fait que tu parles en langue.
Does not mean that you are a prophet.
Ne veut pas dire que tu es un prophète.
The fact that you slept last night and had one dream, and it came to pass.
Le fait que tu as dormi et tu as eu des rêves qui sont réalisés.
It's not yet guaranteed.
C'est pas une garantie.
One thing.
Une chose.
To be called.
Pour être appelé.
Second thing.
L'autre chose.
To answer the call.
Accepter cet appel.
There's a gap between the caller and the person answering the call.
Entre celui qui appelle et celui qui reprend
this
l'appel.
Gap,
cet espace.
You must go through it.
Tu dois traverser cela.
To have experience.
Pour avoir les expériences.
To know who you are praying for.
Pour connaître qui tu
Even
pries
the
pour.
People you pray for, you do not know them.
Même les gens que tu as prié pour, tu ne les connaissais pas.
You do not know those you pray for.
Tu ne les connaissais pas.
It is very dangerous.
C'est très dangereux.
A commissioner.
Un commissionnaire.
To threaten.
Poverty.
A general.
Un général.
If you are called.
Si tu es appelé.
To lay hands.
Pour poser des mains.
When you lay the hands.
Quand tu imposes les mains.
You will see the glory of God upon your life.
Tu verras la gloire de Dieu sur ta
vie. If you are called to teach.
Si tu es appelé à enseigner.
When you teach.
Quand tu enseignes.
The more the people are blessed.
Le plus que les gens sont bénis.
The more you are blessed.
Le plus que tu es béni également.
The day.
Le jour.
You hold somebody's hand.
Tu tiens la main de quelqu'un.
To climb the first step.
Pour faire le premier pas.
If the person succeeds in climbing the first step.
Si il réussit à prendre ce premier step.
And you are not on the second step.
Il n'a pas pris le deuxième pas.
Then there is a problem with you.
Il y a des problèmes avec toi.
That's a parable to you as a man of God.
La parabole pour toi avant que, afin que l'homme.
It's a parable. He understands what I'm talking about.
Il a compris ce que j'ai dit.
When you pray for people to be blessed.
Quand tu pries pour les gens pour être bénis.
Automatically you are blessed.
Automatiquement tu deviens béni.
If something affects your blessing,
quelque chose affecte ta bénédiction.
Then there is a crack in your calling.
Il y a un fissure sur ton appel.
A crack in your calling.
Fissure sur ton appel.
So the crack was repaired last Sunday.
On t'a réparé dimanche passé cette fissure.
That is stage one.
Voilà première étape.
If I may talk to you now,
si je dois te parler maintenant,
as a brother preaching the gospel,
en tant qu'un frère qui prêche l'évangile,
I will say the crack was repaired. That is stage one.
Je dirais que cette fissure était réparée, première étape.
Stage two.
Deuxième étape.
You need to be admitted into the university of God.
Tu dois être admis à l'université de Dieu.
Let God sign your diploma.
Que Dieu signe ton diplôme.
Before you can also sign other people's diplôme.
Avant de signer les diplômes des autres personnes.
It doesn't mean you are not there.
Ça ne veut pas dire que tu n'es pas là.
My brother, it is there,
c'est
but
là.
You have to be admitted.
Tu dois être admis.
You have conferences.
Avoir des conférences.
Teachings.
Enseignements.
Lectures.
Des lectures.
Guardians.
Des guides.
And you'll be taught.
Et tu seras enseigné.
On the principles.
Les principes.
Of spiritual assessment.
D'assessement spirituel.
That is when you will not preach the gospel with contentment.
C'est là où tu prêcheras l'évangile avec contentement.
That is where you are lacking.
C'est là où tu manques.
So God will use me to give that to you.
Dieu m'utilisera pour te donner cela. Amen.
So how are you feeling now?
Comment est-ce que tu te sens
maintenant? I'm feeling very, very fine.
Très bien.
Inside of you, because you came here full of pressure within you. So how is it?
No, I'm feeling fine. Everything is good. I sleep like a baby. I'm so light. I feel so strength.
Clap for Jesus Christ. So your advice?
My advice to viewers of the world, as a man of God who are outside there, you should humble yourself for God to lead you, so that you can, so that God can intervene in your life, so that God can solve your problem. Maybe you are passing through what I passed through as an apostle. But there are higher ranks, there are higher levels, which God helped me to meet, and today my life has changed.
Yes. This is a lesson to me.
Anotus.
There are seeds.
Il y a des semences.
But some seeds are comfortable.
Mais il y a ces semences qui sont confortables.
And some are very hot.
Et d'autres chauffent.
It is predestined that God will use me to deliver him.
Il est prédestiné que
Dieu va le délivrer. The same God will use me to point to. You know, today we men of God we have this. I don't know how to put it in quotes. We find it difficult to console each other to pray within ourselves.
Les hommes de Dieu n'aiment pas prier entre eux-mêmes.
Brother. Pastor, this evangelist, this place, can we have a meeting? We pray together.
Est-ce qu'on peut prier ensemble?
We don't want that.
Nous ne voulons pas cela.
And that is not the gospel God has taught us.
Et ce n'est pas l'évangile que Dieu nous a enseigné.
God taught us the gospel to strengthen one another.
Dieu nous a enseigné l'évangile pour se fortifier l'un et l'autre.
But today is not like that.
Aujourd'hui, c'est pas ainsi.
Everyone, me.
Que personne soit moi.
So we thank God. Amen.
Amen.
But for me, my duty is to raise spiritual giants to preach the gospel to the world. So, your call is there, okay?
Ton appel est là.
Yes, sir.
And you'll be fine.
Et tout ira bien.
So, let's hear from one or two persons. If you have learned something from this man, or you have an advice or a word, anybody in the
God is my
shepherd.
But what I've learned from him, from his testimony, is that there are levels and we should learn to seek guidance from higher levels. There are commissioners and there are generals. He thought because he had that revelation, he was already a general. But thank God he met the man of God, our own apostle, Marcel Chatti.
Clap for him.
The Lord is my shepherd. For what I've learned from the man of God is that if you receive a call from God, you don't just pick your Bible and jump into ministry. To be a man of God, it's a process. It's a university, just like Apostle Marcel Chatham said. You need mentorship. The mere fact that you receive a calling from God does not yet qualify you to enter directly into ministry. Why I say so? Because there are some men of God that have even lost their lives. I brother here, you are lucky because some have died in that battle. Because you go and pray for people when you have not yet been trained, you have not yet been mentored, and you have not yet been blessed and commissioned by a spiritual father. You can be embarrassed by powers. So my advice is that if we receive the call of God, it's good to locate maybe a senior prophet like our father here who can direct you and lead you towards the right direction so that your calling may be successful.
My name is Emmanuel Dengwe. I come from South Africa. I think for me, what I've learned from the young apostle is that his humbleness also after the mistake has given him a trophy.
Wonderful.
Humbleness means recognizing your mistake and seeking God's face has given you a trophy. And indeed, you have received that trophy.
The Lord is our shepherd. And Malantata Belinda. What I've gathered from his testimonies is that in the University of God, there is no double promotion. If you look at the testimony, he went ahead opening a church, whether it was not his time. There is time for everything, and he needed somebody to hold his hand. That was to be his mentor. He went ahead without really seeking the face of God to open his church, to marry a wife. That's how everything covered. So now God has led him to our Father. Our Father is here to see him through. We need a Father, each one of us. There is a parable that says, water be bent because person not the way be directed. We need directions, and God is here to direct us. God has given us somebody to direct us. We are blessed. So we thank God for this testimony, has strengthened our faith this hour, especially servants of God that are out there. We should learn from this testimony. Amen.
So water will not bend again.
Dans l'eau ne va pas se tordre.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it's important that we learn lessons. It is not only to men of God.
Pas juste à l'homme de Dieu.
This lesson is to all of us here.
Cette leçon c'est pour nous tous ici.
Those of you who are doing business.
Ceux qui font des affaires.
You just saw somebody driving a big jeep.
Quelqu'un conduit la voiture.
You start going around doing research. What is the man doing for a living?
Tu fais la recherche. Qu'est-ce qu'il fait?
They say he's a businessman.
On dit qu'il est un homme d'affaires.
You will not leave and go and sell your father's farm in the village to come and do business.
Tu prends le champ de ton père pour faire le business.
In the course of doing, you become frustrated.
Au cours, tu deviens frustré.
Anything you want to do as a calling.
Tout ce que tu fais en tant qu'appel.
Get into the school of it.
Entre l'école de cela.
Learn.
Apprends.
The negative.
Les négatifs.
And the positive part of it.
Et le positif de cela.
That will give you a balanced mindset.
Donnera une pensée équilibrée.
If this apostle, my brother here.
Si cet apôtre, mon frère.
Have learned. The negative and the positive part of it.
On avait appris le positif et le négatif de ce.
And already balanced himself
et
in the middle.
Et équilibré au milieu.
He would have been able to handle the challenges that came his way.
Il pourrait gérer les difficultés.
He was unable to handle them because he had not experience in ministry.
Parce qu'il n'avait pas eu cette expérience dans le
and
ministère.
For you to have experience in ministry.
Il peut avoir cette expérience.
You don't have it when you are forming a ministry.
Tu ne peux pas avoir cela quand tu formes
un ministère. You have it when you walk. Would someone to lead you?
Quand tu travailles avec quelqu'un qui te dirige.
Those challenges will melt you.
Te
mold you.
Te mold.
For God to fill you.
Que Dieu te remplisse.
And cook you for the assignment.
Et t'arranger pour le devoir.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
It's like struggling to swallow a bone you have not chewed.
Comme essayer d'avaler.
You need to chew the bone. You know how hard it is before you swallow it. So in your ministry, you could not advise anyone because you have not had experience. So you are now in the school of experience. Practical gospel that will not prepare you for the crown of that apostle you carry.
Yes, apostle.
Uh-huh.
I want to ask you if I find grace in God. I find grace in your sight. That if you can pardon me, I'll be grateful.
Today is what? Today is 22nd. Today is Sunday. So God will give you a revelation about me on Wednesday.
Thank you.
Wednesday.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
After 1 a.m.
Après 1 heure.
You write it down.
J'écris cela.
You bring it to me on Thursday.
J'amène cela jeudi.
That is what mission letter I'm giving. So God will give you admission letter. Stand up.
So I've got to watch the power of God right here. The apostle receiving impartation from higher grace. You can watch as every wrong foundation is being shaken and uprooted from his life. Watch God's power in action.
Good.
Celebrate that by Jesus.
So you will know yourself.
Amen.
And if we hear him preach,
you
will hear him preaching in the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So let him wait for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.